the GOP establishment is rallying its waning forces and influence behind failed 2012 presidential nominee Mitt Romney, who just picked up the nomination for U.S. Senate in Utah Tuesday, while the resistance from the grassroots left picked up a major win against the establishment of the Democratic Party in New York. This all comes as President Donald Trump keeps winning policy-wise and politically inside his own party, knocking off primary challengers to his endorsed incumbents in South Carolina's gubernatorial contest and in a New York congressional race. Most importantly, in both parties, there appears to be a scrambling by leaders desperate to figure out how to stop Trump. The crumbling GOP establishment turns its gaze to an old friend in Romney, perhaps its wing of the party's last best hope, to slow Trump's roll from the GOP perspective. Incumbent Senators Jeff Flake, R-Oz, and Bob Corker, RTN, frequent critics of the president, are not running for re-election. In their wake, more pro-Trump candidates are emerging. In Tennessee, Representative Marsha Blackburn, RTN, is the presumptive nominee for U.S. Senate. In Arizona, there is a three-way battle between Dr. Kelly Ward, Sheriff Joe Arpaio, and Representative Martha McSally, R-Oz, all of whom present themselves as pro-Trump for the party's nomination for the Senate seat Flake is vacating. Even so, despite all his successes, the globalist establishment wing of the GOP has yet to give up control of all the levers of power to Trump and his band of nationalist populist rebels. That is where Romney comes in. The smooth-talking failed one-time presidential candidate is running for the Senate seat vacated by retiring Senator Orrin Hatch, RUT, and represents the last dying breaths of the old ways of the grand old party. Romney talks the part of a nationalist on matters like China, and has even thrown further right than Trump on some immigration fights, but when it matters, most of those platitudes fall by the wayside and the globalist in Romney resurfaces. How about when American workers have needed Romney most on trade or auto manufacturing policy or immigration policy or standing up to Chinese influence? He talks a good game, but doesn't he deliver the perfect weapon for the GOP establishment to rally behind as it heads into hibernation while Trump gains in popularity? Rallies' historic loss comes amid a larger battle inside the Democratic Party about how best to challenge an increasingly popular and successful Trump. Representative Ro Khanna, DCA, an anti-establishment Democrat who has aligned with his party's rising populist forces, actually endorsed Ocasio-Cortez against Crowley in the primary, a stunning rebuke by a member, albeit a freshman, of his party's leadership. In fact, late Tuesday, Khanna's name, along with several others who have been leading an anti-war charge inside the Democratic Party for a restriction of U.S. military action in Yemen and elsewhere, was floated for a potential Democratic Party leadership role. All of this, perhaps most interestingly, sets up a pure base-driven political dynamic heading into November. Two movements, Trump's populist movement and the left's resistance movement, face off in November. Which one wins determines the future of the country.